where Nathan Hale was a teacher. It's now in New London, Connecticut. It's a beautiful little building. And upstairs you can see where the students in chalk wrote their names years and years ago. So yeah, inside of this building are the signatures of the pupils in his classroom. He was a terrific man, and we gathered together to give thanks for him. And he lived a real life. He was a real person who made a real sacrifice for the United States of America. And so today we give thanks for his life. He lived his life in a complicated world like many of us, where there are all kinds of forces and pressures in all directions. But he cared enough for his students, and he cared enough for us, because he believed there would be a future. There would be people like us who would remember cause of the American Revolution. So let us pray. Almighty God, you are the creator and sustainer of the whole human family. We pause today to give you thanks for the life of your child, Nathan Hale. We thank you for his courage, his wisdom, and his stamina, and for the prophetic vision that shaped not only his life, but the lives of countless other people. And from generation to generation, men and women have risen to give thanks for his life and to praise his sacrifice and wisdom. Bless this time we have together, that it might be used to your honor and glory, and that we may never forget the price of the establishment of the United States of America. Amen.
City Hall Park to commemorate, ironically, the hanging of Nathan Hale, one of the first martyrs to the American Revolution. Nathan Hale was a young Yale graduate and a classmate of Benjamin Talmadge, whose family provided the funds to acquire Jones's Tavern. And Benjamin Talmadge recruited Nathan Hale to investigate the condition of New York, go behind enemy lines. Unfortunately, he was found out, and since he was a spy, he was summarily condemned to be hanged without any sort of trial whatnot. Nathan Hale is also honored at the CIA headquarters in Washington, which regards 1776 as the date of their founding. So he is given credit as one of the originators, along with George Washington, of our intelligence agency, and he stands for and represents the many more spies who operated more successfully, including the famous Culper Ring, and who were managed by Benjamin Talmadge, for whose diary and daybook we treasure in the Bronx's Tavern Museum, and it provided us account of George Washington saying farewell to his troops. So it's a great honor once again to be giving credit to one of our original and early martyrs in Haiti.